just your emotions, you know, as that, as they make that kick, and just what's going through your mind and your heart at that moment and right now?
I'm disappointed. You know, it's not what we wanted, but the great thing about football is we get to come back tomorrow and look at the film and be able to correct the mistakes that were made today on both sides of the ball. I mean, it's a team loss. We let up on defense. I can say we lit up too many big plays. We knew it was going to be a passing game. So when that, you know, when that happens, and you know you prep for it all week, and it still happens, and you're shocked. I don't know what else to say, but get to the film, fix it.
Jack gathered the team there right for the fourth quarter. What was kind of the message in that moment?
Yeah. So Coach Rule just kind of. We had all realized that when we played against Illinois, we all came together in the fourth quarter, and Illinois is probably the best ball we've played all year. You could feel the emotion. You could feel the energy from both sides, from every aspect on the team. You know, my message to them was that, you know, this is the game that we love. This is the type of game we want to be in. This is a Big Ten football game. So it's going to come down to the playmakers, and it's going to come down to each and every one of us to go out there and finish it out. Unfortunately, no, didn't go our way again. So let's get back to it this week.
Is that the kind of energy you're trying to channel going forward these last two games, that Illinois energy you're talking about?
Yeah, I mean, that's the standard. I mean, each week the standard is raised, and I mean, I even raised it today for myself. You know, I played a pretty good game today. And, you know, it has to happen again next week. Can't take and no games off. Not saying that anyone takes a game off, but and we know in the D-line room that's going to cut, like, the D-line sets the tone of the game. And you know, going forward, it's just how can we raise that standard and get everyone else on board together.
What is the challenge of just those sudden change situations that you guys had to keep coming out and you get 5 turnovers today on offense?
I mean, I wouldn't say there's really no challenge. We love playing defense. You know, it's part of the game. It's unfortunate, but our job as a defense is to go and do the same thing. You know, the way you could fight that is telling us that we can go get more turnovers. And, you know, we went in at halftime, that was the message. You know, it was that there was no, you know, corrections or anything like that. It was more of go get that ball. And then, you know, Omar comes out and one of the first plays and gets a fumble and recovers it. And Buddha gets a pick, and then Omar gets another fumble. And, you know, we start seeing the ball kind of playing into our favor, and you know, should have been happening all game, not till the third and fourth quarter.
How good of a quarterback was
Tagovailoa? Yeah, he's a good passer, and he's shifty and he's fast. I mean, he about got me when he threw that interception to Buddha, but we just knew all week that he was gonna like to roll out. He's like to spin out to his left and roll out wide to his right, and we just knew that if we were rushing him, that don't give him the step-up lane in the B gap and kind of rush him on his upfield shoulder and kind of wider, so when he decides to spin, you can meet him at the spin, or if he wants to roll out, meet him at when he likes to roll out at his depth. So, yeah, he's a hell of a player.
All good. All right, thanks.